WordPress multisite is a powerful feature of WordPress that can be confusing at times, but can be very useful in others. If you go to the WordPress.org codex, you can search about how to create a network, and this will explain how to set up your WordPress to be a WordPress multisite. Any self-hosted WordPress on HostGator or Bluehost or GoDaddy or one of those can be turned into a WordPress multisite, so you can have dozens or hundreds of blogs out of your single installation of WordPress. The only thing you really need to do is to be able to edit your WP config file and add one line of code, and that'll get it going. There's more to it to do it right, but that'll kind of get it started. You can read up on the codex and other places all about how to do it. Some good examples of multi-sites to get you an idea of what they are. Again, it's one installation of WordPress that powers many sites, the biggest of which is WordPress.com. WordPress.org, of course, lots of people have hosted, but if you set up a free site on WordPress.com, you're part of their big multi-site with millions of other people. Other uses for it could be blog networks or universities or corporate sites or anything where you want similar websites all in one place, easy to manage in one place. They can be public, like EduBlogs. You can go in here and get a free blog with them. They've got 4.3 million on there, powered by a WordPress multi-site. You can get a free blog and join their community on their WordPress multi-site. And others use WordPress multi-site for public information, but not just anyone can join. And a good example of that is the New York Times blogs. So for them, they have a bunch of different blogs, but they can manage it all through one WordPress installation. You can't sign up and join it, but they don't have to keep track of dozens of different WordPress sites. They can just have one installation to keep up with in terms of plugin updates and themes and all that kind of stuff, and not have to deal with managing all those separate websites. So it can be great for that kind of thing. If you have different websites you need to build that serve very different purposes, you're typically better to build separate WordPress installations, but WordPress multi-site can be very useful at times, and I hope this helped explain that a little bit for you.